Which movie?
Black in the Rear.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. I'm the last son. Anyone from here? So why are we all here today? We're here to celebrate the marriage and union of Alistair and Yvonne. In today's ceremony, they both here to see each other for the rest of their lives. But people get married for all different types of reasons. Some people get married for tax reasons. Some people get married to have children. Some people get married because they get married at all. But not least, you can see that these are not married because they are in love. And that is a beautiful thing. Well, I know there's a lot of love in this room today, but I'm not really feeling it just yet. It's an unusual meeting. So we're going to stand up, everyone, come on. And I'd like you all to hope the person to your left and the person to your right, and tell them how much you love them.
Allowing you to jump in for the moment.
seen you look better than she. Anyway, we're here. This is a letter to you, Professor Schultz, where I also managed to sort of really special. The small, slightly satisfied look on his face indicates to me where he's just fallen. Seconds before the picture is in there. He also previously has a look at you and I mean, that's a person. He's had a moment to say something to me. I thought he'd be sick. I'm sight on him, I'm smell on him. Slight cheeky rise of the eyebrows seems to say, I thought, what are you doing on him? We don't need to be careful there, he's a very big mistake, but it's really slight on him. I do look forward to when I'm shot at the energies there, the policy very interesting. Definitely. His house on his night bed wearing 5-year-old summer day helmet. Told you where the face was, isn't it? About this time is when a little bear's lady changes and Chase Island was the first sought after the soil market. Poopies were making their bed on his bottles, washing bottles, but not in the O'Brien household. No. Mum had her feet when she was over the table at all of us at this point, and I managed to serve a much wanted toy to the carriage to the end of the crisis in school. The same could not be said the year after when a woman moved to see a crystal company from BC. And I've seen four crystal whistle tumblers and a carriage in place. Alistair's Christmas made a threat to drop the taste by what James next door to the very time. These included remote show cars, bikes, but my particular favourite was the remote sweet coffee phase. I don't particularly remember a frying sweet coffee scene at the time, but watching the boat struggling to hit the pork, didn't even have a ball, a pork, across the pumpkin top line was a Christmas item.
I didn't even have skates.
I know. Alison didn't even have skates. Although while that is might not have been a good student, Alison does want to partake in various other sports. Although very willing, even Alison would admit he's not the finest football player. He's not that bad, however, when he's second for our Monday night football games, our John does ask if Angela is available before Alison. Alistair is a decent rugby player. His first facility is back. I've seen him play every position from 9 through to 15. However, Alistair's favourite position is there fly half. Pulling the strings at the centre of the action. This is also closer to the scrum, so there's less chance of a severe lack of pace being exposed by a speedy winger. Is the pitch Alistair in action? He's dictating the way there now. I can't quite make out that he's doing a really slow pitch pass. And this time I've got a new round, I'm shooting the ball, or Alistair's hanging on to the ball too long, and he's had enough, and he's getting off. I also don't think it's that. I don't think it's not to do anything either for you. Alistair's first round of sorting when we came during the Tesco Bank game for World. It was early on in the match as the ball went out of play. Alistair was clearly pumped up the game, so desperate to get the ball back into play as soon as possible. So it was facing the world pressure. A spectator from the opposition grabbed the ball in a bit of slow play down, and seeing this, Alistair punched the spectator clean in the face. Such was the severity of the punch, Alison knocked the young girl clean out of her wheelchair. Alison only pushed her own, standing of my glasses in person. Some may mind with a simple attitude, but even as a legitimate, he may perhaps throw the song of our brother and age. For those of you who don't know, I'm going to put their name on this time. But this is Alice today, so let's not go into that right now. However, I feel that he's hired his pull technique. He needs to be lower over the head, left. You need the left arm to the right leg, snap the shaking leg over. Okay? Come and see me in a while afterwards, we're going to go in again, okay? I have no problem with this issue today. What is going on there? Hello, lady! Hello there. Alison Ron Holbert's up there long before the podcast got all of this. You look like a prominent bee on his day today. You may also notice this week, you can't really miss those teeth. What are they, my friend, right? They look like two pieces of chemo and pizza and love. But it's good to see Sammy wearing it today. It was about this age that Alistair started taking interest in girls. Well, Spice Girls to take that. Yeah, Alistair's first concert was a Spice Girl. What a man. Worse still, the young velvet girls and Chris Longworth. These two trendy mutants, absolutely matchings, were popping about sports, bathing, and wrestling. They were The disappointments of this guy from the last few tickets this year, they were short lived. As their front row tickets to smash it home as well as dropping it off for us. Oh, yes, the hair. You look at Alison's hair, but we'll just put a few on the hair side today. I think you're going to really know what looks very bad, even with his massive hair. So before the hair shape was invented, Alison's hair is made from a very coarse, waterproof wire. The likes have never been seen before. Scientists from Birdhouse and Sprayway have taken samples of his Gore-Tex hair to try and reverse the numbers of the waterproof. In this picture, Alison's features lower his hair with regard hairstyle, and has resulted in dipping his hair in a tin of gloss every morning in the household. Even with the advent of straightener, Alistair is still prone to a bad hair day, as is proven by this stinky mortar. A young patch on. The science of the series, the bad says I'm ready to part. However, this bad partner didn't stop him from chatting with his first girlfriend. Please note, this is the only girl that I remember from him. From the wonderful law. Is that right?
Yeah.
Anyway, I already met her once at some family bureau. It turned out she was with a fortune teller with a palm reader and proceeded to use her every syllable powers to read everyone's harmless address from her, often telling her about her impending doom. Anyway, that was the last I saw of her. Sensibly, I think I was to come up with her like that. I think she wants to see that one coming over there. Come on, we're going to go back. Now, I'm not sure whether this is about his redneck hairstyle, but dark clouds are on the horizon as Alistair went a little bit off the rails. Always, the famous phone grill. The angle of lines, 133 horses under the bonnet. It could only be the road 620. long it be under the sun on my past pride and joy. Oh, long I learned from this night, oh, and that I know God for a few years. That morning we put the clouds in bed with a polish and a little piece of a polish. God, you know that car. Alison took this opportunity to see that I'm an empty guest and a few of those friends. A few hours later, the slide was just getting going, the party slide was running low. Alison didn't get out to get what he needed quickly before the party died. He looked out the window, saw the road and listening in the moonlight. He turned to see the key lying on the table. He saw what the man was stifling all. The decision was made. He was taking the road. Meanwhile, Mum and Dad were still out with friends. Mum was chatting away. Dad looked wistfully out the window, thinking of the flame red beast he left at home. He really did all that wrong. Both were aware of the events that were about to unfold. Back in the house, Alistair and Gareth together in a crew. Now I know you're thinking it's probably all a bit grand theft, but also Alistair took the wheel, captain, jaunty angle, big extra rap player on the sound system. There's probably a few reactions, Yancy Bell on the back seat, and they're off to get some liquor and score some passes. Sadly, this was not the case. Alison sat at the wheel with his hand to attend to. He had really fallen under it from when it was in the car earlier. There was no reactions, just my sins and softness, although these may have been sanity part. And to top it all off, there was no drugs or liquor, they were going to the shop for wham bars. Bloody wham bars. Anyway, Alice set off on a short trip to Top Shots. The few driver messages we had left all being prepared for the raw power of the 2 litres of engine. But he didn't come too far. He made it to the top roundabouts and hung right towards that of the shots. Gathering pace, Alice lost control. He bounced one gear to another. The boys in the back braced themselves for the inevitable. Meanwhile, back at home and back, Mum was still chatting away. He knew something was wrong. He had a sixth sense, such was the pain with this car. He knew what was about to happen. He stood up. No! Alison 17 years passed before his eyes. He saw two pedestrians on the pavement. He slapped back from the nerve as the boy hit him in his bystands. He swerved away, the car hit to the car, came to a resounding halt. Such was the severity of the impact. Alistair knocked the two young female pedestrians clean out of their wheelchairs. He took out of the car to see if they were all right and stood on their glasses in process. Like a good easy word, seeing the Thomas one of their toes and legs. Might say once to see with your eyes, I think that's why he's wearing a suit. In the days that followed, I wrote in my newfound status as not the worst son. Dad was obviously devastated, but he put the wheels back on, put it in the air freshener, and sold the car to a budget. I thought he would be so forgiving when I was so nice on Peter. After that story, I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome my mom, Gordon, Siobhan, Karen, and all of the extended family to the old Ryan home. We'll be like going on and be so good as that. No, seriously, I think you all agree they are wonderful people, and it's a pleasure to welcome them into the family. Because she's a Jekyll family, I know what they're going to be listening on here today. So I've spoken to Samantha, as a gift to you, if you read it, I'm going to share on the shows with you all today. So if you see me after the speech, copies of Rosa, okay? This is, of course, his graduation day. We're at the world of the 200 business suite. He sits along to do something or other with spreadsheets, which is all very boring. But seriously, Alistair has pursued a career in accounting. He has only one more exam to complete before he's fully qualified, I can't wait. This has been going forward for years, one rival job satisfaction. Short hours and no money about his job and family function. Just like me. When you qualify, you can buy a room for the test as this picture taken in the sand room. We always dress for the first night, but this is the second night. Both of them fall zone. Whilst on the subject of sand night, a big thank you to everybody who came. See if you wouldn't mind there. It was a quiet, almost solemn weekend where we all had the chance to reflect on love, marriage, and obviously what else are my needs to us. Seriously though, despite what they said about all your mates, I thought most of them were all right. Except Pets, you were right about it. Keeping with sad group theme, whilst away, some of them all, 20 drinks and few minutes, often trying to entice it in by offering free drinks for the best man on the side. Although I'm a thoroughly modern man, also a stickler for tradition, and I'm sure Alistair will agree on this one, that this is one tradition that's worth keeping, for tonight at least. So just to reiterate, best man's stag, drink for free, yeah? He's a stag, and I'm the best man, yeah? I'll see you at the bar, okay? Near the end of the speech now, we managed to get over this way, we got one who were all making any salty guys. A little bit serious now. I was genuinely honest, yes, as Alistair's best man today. And I'm going to mention you. There we go. I was genuinely honest, yes, as Alistair's best man today. Plus, you know, as he said before, despite the A championship, I do consider one of my very best friends, and I love him today. But what I can do, I'm sure, as a guy anyone mentioned before, was absolutely stunning. And she is this perfect match. They've been together for so long, I couldn't imagine what went on with them. I touched on it before, but obviously they are very much in love. And my one tip to you is to keep out the love. For instance, every year on our wedding anniversary, I get a card from Ruby, and sometimes I even send them one back. Anyway, although I've been with you before, I'd like to all be understanding, please. Raising glasses for the bride and groom, Alistair and Yvonne. To them. also for me also a big hand because they're all really small. Thank you. I'm actually for, because I love the boat so much, I play with the person. I mentioned earlier about some of his Christmas presents, the snow hockey, the Christmas glasses, but all he ever really wanted was one of these. There we go. Thank you.